sometimes that they may not be so open to talk about it at the very beginning. So I think that we need to facilitate them that it's okay to say it out. But then patient will say that, no, I don't want my children worry about me. I don't want my husband worry that I'm so scared, and I just want to keep it inside so that I don't want to have more than one people that they have so much worry, right? So, and also for them, they will say that, well, my children, they are busy enough. They have to work or they have to study. So I don't want them to know too much, or I don't want them to worry that affect their own life. So I have to help the patients to understand that, even though you don't talk to them, you talk much about your feelings like that, but do you think that they will know about what's going on? Because they can see from your face, they know that you are worried. They know that you have some kind of things hidden inside. So I will suggest them that talk a little bit, and also explain to the family members that, that I just want you to listen. But after I talk about it or I cry, you let me cry, then I will be okay, I will feel better. I will encourage patients that, let the family members know that I need to say it out. But it doesn't mean that I don't have that ability to cope, or to let the patients know that, let your children know not only you to handle the things, but you have a team supporting you. If your children ask you questions that you don't know how to answer, just bring the questions back to the team, and so that we all or the doctor can answer it. So this is the way that I encourage patients that to keep their communication open.